Hey, it's Greg here with MaritimeGardening.com, and I was out harvesting the potatoes in this bed, and I thought I would do a video just walking through that process of harvesting the potatoes, how I dry them out and prepare them for storage, dealing with the bed, you can see I'm pulling some weeds there. I mean, I just put the potatoes down, put the mulch down, and just leave it all season. And I mean, this bed, I have pulled some potatoes out of it off and on throughout since around August, just for various meals. And the potatoes growing in here are russet Burbank variety. But I haven't really done a thorough end-to-end, let's get all the potatoes out of the garden and put the bed down for the winter and just leave it. So that's what I'm going to do here. I'm pulling all the potatoes and I'm drying out the potatoes for storage. And I'm gonna mulch the bed and sort of put it down for the winter. Here I am just, what I like to do is I go over the bed by hand first. You can see I'm pulling some weeds there and just setting them aside. I'm gonna shred those all up and throw them back on the, I'm gonna use the weeds as a mulch. I'm gonna use all the weeds in the surrounding area as a mulch, in fact, and I'll walk you through that whole process. But yeah, I go through the garden by hand first, just pulling back the mulch and finding what I can find that way. And then I go over it with a tool. I get this thing called a homey digger. I find it does a pretty good job at getting the potatoes up without damaging them too much. And I'd like to not wait too long to do this. Here I got a potato with, it's got a hole bored into it. And I'm gonna break it open here and see what's in that, what bored its way into it if it's still in the potato. I find if you leave the potatoes too long, this is middle of September when I filmed this, and if you leave them in too long, you just run a greater and greater risk of the potato becoming compromised and something boring into it and turning it into a very gross potato. So what I found in there, I don't know how well you can see that on the screen, but there's a little, almost looks like a snail shell. It isn't. It's almost like the shell from a pupa stage of some thing that got in there. So yeah, that's just one more reason. And I know there's different theories on this and different approaches, but I have found if you leave them in there too long, I mean, once the plants die, the potatoes are ready to be harvested. And if you leave them in too long, there's just an increasing risk of them being compromised. When is too late to leave them? For me, whenever we get our first frost, I start throwing all my energy and getting potatoes out of the ground. Because if you got any potatoes near the surface, they could get a bit too cold and they could get damaged and they won't store well. So I consider the first frost of the season to be the indication to get out there and get those potatoes out of the ground. And I've got almost all my potatoes. I think I've got two beds of potatoes left to go, and I'll try to have those by the end of September, probably this weekend. That's September 25th right now as I'm recording this. So here you can see, because I mean, you can only take so much of me digging up potatoes, but just getting in there and going crazy. You can see I'm kind of sitting weird. On my left knee, I actually ruptured the bursa sac on that knee almost a year ago. And it takes a very long time to heal. And I've done all my gardening all this season without the ability to kneel on my left knee. I can kneel on it, but I have to be very careful and gentle in how I do it, or otherwise I get an incredible pain in it. Anyway, poor me, I know there's people worse off. So here I am now. I've gone over the garden with my bare hands, and I've gone over the garden with the homey gardening tool, and now I'm using the fork, which I imagine a lot of people would start with the fork, but I find when I use the fork to harvest potatoes, I skewer the odd potato. And I mean, I guess if I was doing this, if I was working on a farm or something, this would be, there'd be one guy working the fork and there'd be maybe two guys going around picking all the potatoes up. But for just me in my backyard, it's different sort of, it's not an industrial production type thing. So I find this is the best way to minimize the damage you do to your potatoes. The really large potatoes are the ones you want to put in storage anyway. And the fork's most likely to skewer them more than anything else. Now I think I went off here to grab a board, so I just thought it would be easier or ergonomically for me to stand in the middle of the bed while I was doing this forking. So rather than compress the soil too much, it's not a big deal. I could have just stood in there, but there was a board like 8 feet away, so it was no big deal just to throw a little 2x6 down, and it was that way it sort of evens out the pressure that my my own weight. I'm like 200, a little bit over 200 pounds. Not going to say how much, but no reason to compress the soil unnecessarily. As I've said before, harvesting potatoes and getting in there and digging the soil up, it's good therapy if you're going through any sort of tilling withdrawal from being a no-till gardener. I'm a no-till gardener, but I have to admit I do take a pleasure in forking over soil. Although I'm glad I don't have to fork over all the soil in my entire garden. That's a hell of a chore. But doing a couple beds like this to get the potatoes out is great. And here I am just smoothing everything out, making everything even. And then the plan is to bring a weed whacker in. I could use a lawnmower here, but it's kind of a pain. This is about as far from my house and from the garden shed where I keep all of my gear. It's kind of a pain to get lawnmower out to this part of the garden, so I thought I'd try to shred the stuff up using a weed whacker. Here's what I do to dry the potatoes out. I just leave them out in the sun for a couple hours. A couple hours isn't going to bother a potato too much. If you leave it out in the sun for days, it'll turn green. That's not good. It kind of creates a little sort of a toxic effect. But for a couple hours, it's a good quick way to dry them out and get them ready for storage. I just leave them like that and turn them over with a broom a couple times. So here I am with the weed whacker. This is I got one of these cordless weed whackers this summer, and I gotta say I'm really happy with this. It's a 20 volt. And I know people are gonna ask, so it's a DeWalt. I know I don't get any money from DeWalt. I bought this with my own money and they don't give me nothing. But I know people will ask. I can do my whole property about twice with this thing without charging it. It's got all the power could possibly want, and it's doing a great job here. Anyway, it's just easier to haul this out to the garden as opposed to bringing out a lawnmower. This is pretty far from where I keep my lawnmower, and it's a bit of a lawnmower would do a better job of this process because it's, you know, you can put the bag on and just shred it all up. But this part of my garden, it's a bit of a pain to get the mower out here, so I thought give a weed whacker a try. I did a pretty good job. I mean, not the most efficient way to do it, but certainly this thing only weighs like, I don't know, 10 pounds or something like that, maybe less than that. So certainly a lot easier. So the process is just shred it up with the weed whacker and then rake the stuff in. And of course, as soon as you get it raked in, you realize you need to go over it with the weed whacker again. But that's all I did. Just worked my way around and went at it with the weed whacker. And yeah, I'm totally happy with how this works. I know people were seeing me harvest the potatoes earlier and saying, oh, well, you know, you got your potatoes got damaged, you know, that's not good, and so on and so forth. I think we focus way too much on trying to find some perfect way to do everything. I mean, a couple damaged potatoes in a sea within, you know, filled a box there of potatoes, and there was maybe a couple, maybe, I don't know, maybe five in that whole thing that had to be thrown out. That's fine. You know, I don't know what went wrong, and I don't care. If it's only five, I'm not going to dwell on it. You know, I think people dwell too much on perfect results and so on. I put these in the ground, probably took about 10 minutes to plant them, if that, and didn't do anything all season long. So for me, that's kind of what I'm driving for, right? A garden that takes care of itself, that requires no effort on my part. So these weeds at the end, they're on the edge of the walking path. You can't see, but in front of where I'm standing, there's a sand walkway. And my main garden, all the walking paths are sand. I ran out of sand for this section of the garden here. You can see the walking path between the two beds. Where I'm standing, that walking path is just all weeds. As I didn't do anything with it. It's just wild weeds and that sort of thing. Anyway, just giving that area over there a second going over and getting a bit closer to the ground and just shredding it up. But that's the general process. For those people that are going to ask, yes, I'm going to bring more sand in and try to get the entire build, or entire garden with the sand pathways in between them. I'm really happy with how that worked. And I know lots of people use wood chips, but good thing about sand is once you get it there, it doesn't break down. So you don't have to keep, it's a very hard work to get it in, but once you got it, you got it. It's not going to break down. It's rocks. And it does hold a hell of a lot of heat, I got to say. So anyway, that's the process, just raking her up. And I mean, look how much sort of mulch I got. And that green stuff is really good for building the soil. I'll probably throw another bag of leaves. You know, the leaves are going to start falling soon, and people are going to start raking them up and bagging them up and putting them at the end of their driveway really soon. And once that happens, I start grabbing some every day. I just pulled a maple tree out of the ground. A proud Canadian maple. Just pulled it out of the ground. But yeah, once people start throwing away their leaves, I grab as much as I can. And yeah, the amount of mulch I have on here, it's probably about 2 or 3 inches. And I'd like to add a bit more before it's put down for the winter. But for today, or for that day, the day I was doing that, I was done. So that's my general process for putting down a potato garden. I think that whole thing probably took half an hour at the most from beginning to finish. That's not bad. Not bad for, Sunday, Saturday afternoon. I hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please like, share, subscribe. Check out my podcast, maritimegardening.com. Don't forget to click the bell. And until next time, get out there, get at it, have fun in your garden. Thanks for watching.